afternoon and welcome to the Advent Gathering. My name is Peter Huang and I'm one of the leaders of the gathering, a space for Asian Pacific American spirituality. We're a ministry of the Episcopal Diocese of Los Angeles that seek to provide opportunities for conversation and spirituality among Asian Pacific Americans and our allies. We're so glad to experience this Advent season together with you today. I'd like to invite our event host, Bishop Suffragan Diane Jardine Bruce, to welcome you and pray for our time together.
Welcome all. It is such a joy to be with you today. I bring you greetings from Bishop Taylor and Canon McCarthy, who are with us, showing their full support of all that is done here at the gathering. So thank you, Bishop Taylor. Thank you, Canon McCarthy. And again, on behalf of the Diocese of Los Angeles, it's so good to see so many of you here for this event today. And as today is the Feast of the Virgin of Guadalupe, I thought I'd start us out with a prayer for the Virgin, which is so applicable for all of us, especially today. Let us pray. Be present with us, God, our deliverer, as you were present with La Virgen de Guadalupe, who called Juan Diego her beloved son. May her example of tender care for the poor and oppressed guide us in the way of justice and mercy through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
Thank you, Bishop Diane. Each week during the Advent season, we light candles symbolizing our longing for an experience of hope, love, joy, and peace. Our last candle, the Christ candle, we light to declare that Christ brings us hope, love, joy, and peace with his coming. Advent lessons and carols is traditionally a liturgy that offers readings and music that help us prepare for Christmas. Today, we will have members and friends of the gathering and in our diocese share our own interpretation of lessons and carols. We will also have time to reflect together as a gathering. We hope that God meets you in special ways through this time together. I'd like to invite Joyce Swaving to offer our bidding prayer.
Precious Lord, in this season of Advent, we yearn for presence. Our lives are packed full of heart-numbing waiting and longing for the shoe to drop, the pot to boil, the coffee to brew, for that one special love. Upon reflection, could it be that we've been waiting for you to show up if only we would simply slow down and breathe? You see, we've been waiting to be happy, for things to change, and then, of course, for them to get back to normal, whatever that was. Can we ever stop climbing, striving, and take the time to pause? If only we would slow down and invite you in. The merry-go-round of waiting for the next best thing just around the bend to be richer and happier could stop. Our eyes were looking in all the wrong places, searching in the vast and endless spaces for what can only be found by the heart. Let us pause for a moment to cast our eyes up and long instead for the source of hope, love, joy and peace. May we wake up out of our delusion and be brought to our knees, to that place where we stand still and find refuge from our longing. Under the star, where wise folks come to adore him. A humble child born on a silent night. There we find a servant, a healer, a comforter, a miracle worker, the light of the world, who brings freedom from that longing, striving, and waiting. from that lowly manger where our wounds are healed, will we find a reprieve from the danger of our self-imposed blindness and step into the promise of God's loving kindness. There, our tattered hope and faith will awaken. Our struggling and endless striving and searching will be gently taken from us, replaced by the balm of otherworldly, patient, boundless, enduring, liberating, revolutionary love. In this time of uncertainty and prolonged darkness, life-giving beloved, you are our light, our companion on the way and our source of hope and joy. Thank you, Lord Jesus, for transforming our endless longing into glorious belonging. Amen.
We light the first Advent candle of hope. Hope deferred makes the heart sick, but a longing fulfilled is a tree of life. Proverbs 13:12. For hope, the lesson will be offered by Ravi Verma, and the carol will be offered by Dustin Seo.
Hello, everyone. I hope this is Advent-y enough for today. So we've heard so much about what kind of year 2020 has been for us. It's been unsettling, uncertain, unmappable. And here, in the midst of all this, we are in the season of Advent, and asked to wait with expectation. What does that look like? What does that mean? I want to offer you, and I ask you just to come with open hearts, to consider taking on the spiritual practice during this time of embracing the unknown. You know, it's like we talk about holy darkness. Imagine embracing the holy unknown. You know, in uncertain times, in unknowing times, my tendency is to fight it, escape it, find a way out of it, maybe grudgingly accept. So what does it look like? What does it feel like to welcome, to embrace holy unknowing? And the truth is, I don't know. And part of this is to rest in that stance of unknowing, to take that posture. And as Merton says, our very desire to be in the unknowing is what pleases God. And why I think we can do that is because we know from our own experience, from the story, that in the midst of that unknowing, God is there. God will meet us there. And that gives us hope. That gives us hope to be in that unknowing, to welcome it, to explore its contours, to explore the shape of it, the form of it. And when we can't see clearly in the darkness, when we don't know, maybe we'll hear something new. Maybe we'll taste a new beginning. Imagine, you know, Jonah in the whale and Israelites in the Exodus, in that unknowing. They didn't go happily. They complained at times. And I look at Mary, pregnant with Jesus in the womb. She had heard the news and she pondered. I wonder what her stance of pondering the unknown did to Jesus in the womb. In that way, and you know, and I think of my parents who were refugees when the British partitioned India and Pakistan. How did they make that thousands of miles journey? So in embracing the unknown, that dry soil becomes a fertile womb. It becomes a place where hope can be with us, knowing that God is in there. And maybe you and I will hear a new song. Maybe we'll know the next small step in this journey. Maybe we'll trust more that God will lead us into a new day. Thank you.
Hello, everyone. My name is Dustin. And as I prepared my offering of hope, I asked myself the question, what did hope look like in 2020? And for me, I kept coming back to the patience of hope, the pause of hope, the prayer of hope. And that in these uncertain times, we were sometimes uncomfortably put into a place of pause. But hope doesn't just stop at pause and reflection. Hope also extends into response, that a place of prayer turns into action and empowered by our Lord. So as I was picking the carol to play, I gravitated towards a song by Bob Marley called Redemption Song. And as many of you know, Bob Marley was quite a figure of action and has been such an integral part of the redemption of not only Jamaica, but also the African continent, and that many of his later songs and albums were dedicated to the freeing of Africa. Redemption Song is one of the last songs he wrote. It is part of his last album, Uprising, and it holds this space of prayer, but with the caveat of action afterwards. So I'd like to share the lyrics of the song, and I hope you enjoy and find peace in this offering. Old pirates, yes, they rob I. Sold I to the merchant ships, minutes after they took I from the bottomless pit. But my hand was made strong by the and the Almighty. Weave forward in this generation triumphantly. Won't you help me sing these songs of freedom? 'Cause all I ever have, redemption songs. Redemption songs. Emancipate yourselves from mental slavery. None but ourselves can free our minds. Have no fear for atomic energy, 'cause none of them can stop the time. How long shall they kill our prophets while we stand aside and look? Some say it's just part of it. We've got to fulfill the book. Won't you help to sing these songs of freedom? 'Cause all I ever have, redemption songs, redemption songs. Thank you.
We like this. Oh, I'm sorry. We light the second candle, Advent candle of love. Beloved, let us love one another because love is from God. Everyone who loves is born of God and knows God. Whoever does not love does not know God, for God is love. God's love was revealed among us in this way. God sent his only Son into the world so that we might live through him. 1 John 4:7 through 9. For love, the lesson will be offered by Jason Chu, and the carol will be offered by Jenny Kim.
What's up, everybody? My name's Jason Chu. It's an honor to be joining you this Advent season. I hope that y'all are enjoying, y'all are safe, y'all are warm, y'all are comfortable, and y'all know that you're loved. This poem that I'm going to share with y'all, it's off of my last album called Living Room, and this poem is called Dumplings. It's a little bit of a tribute. It's an homage. It's my way of expressing appreciation and thanks to my grandmother, who's, you know, she's Thai Chinese. She was born in Bangkok. She immigrated to America with my father and his brothers. And then now, you know, I get to make this music. I get to create this culture built on the foundation that she and her generation and my ancestors, you know, created for us. So again, thank you so much for letting me be a part of this time and this space. My name is Jason Chu. This poem is called Dumplings. Hope y'all are having a great Advent season. Russell Jung says, Chinese people can speak two love languages fluently, food and sacrifice. Every time I visit her apartment, my grandma does two things. She cooks pan-fried dumplings, and she presses a new $100 bill into my hand, Benjamin Franklin wrapped in a red robe like an emperor. She lives across from the Montgomery Mall, where we walk after lunch, bellies straining to search up and down the aisles at KB Toys. I lie on her carpet through the late afternoons, playing with my new Legos as she watches the Chinese news on her old TV. Grandma is an immigrant, worked to support three sons, knows how to leave everything behind, knows these dollars are nothing more than a nursery of fading green, a paper-thin cocoon transforming labor into life. What kind of idiot collects shed skin and dead hair and calls that life? I do. For 2 months, my friend David hid every mirror in his house, turning frames and taping up newspaper until he was living in a perpetual state of tornado readiness. He said the more he looked at himself, the less he saw others. I'm afraid to accept that I've forgotten how to see you, grown used to seeing what I need from you. Terrified to confess that I care more about what I'm saying than who I'm saying it to. That's not language, it's a mirror. And isn't our world filled with mirrors, kisses like cold glass and songs clear and clean like the air in a bank? Maybe the answer is learn from grandma. I'll cook you your favorite food, press into your hand my stored labors, which you will spend on late afternoons with me. If we're gonna live in a world where kisses taste like summer and songs sing like two palms warm against each other, I'm going to need to learn to speak in a language I haven't yet mastered, but need to. We speak two languages fluently, food and sacrifice. Speak two languages fluently, food and sacrifice.
Come, let's go. nella fantasia andò, esiste un vento caldo che soffia sulle città.
We're going to pause our lessons and carols for a moment, and we're going to break up into breakout groups of about five people for 10 minutes. And we're going to share with one another this question. In the midst of the pandemics plaguing our world today, where have you seen hope, love, joy, and peace in your life? We've heard two very good examples of hope and love so far, and I hope you can use this time to share with one another. So Mel, we're gonna go into breakout groups now.
We light the third Advent candle of joy. The Lord is my strength and shield. I trust him with all my heart. He helps me, and my heart is filled with joy. I burst out in songs of thanksgiving. For joy, the lesson will be offered by Sharon Crandall, and then we will listen to a carol offered by Gukhui Han.
The other Marys radiated joy. The disciples found the truth hard to believe. There had to be breaking bread, eating fish, before they too, even Thomas, were lit with joyfulness. Not much was said about me. I said goodbye to the son I carried within me for 9 months, nursed, fed, and taught to walk. On Friday, when they took him down from the cross, I held the son I knew, recognizing him in my arms, and never saw him again, not my body's child. How could I laugh, weep tears of joy? Like the others, I failed to recognize him. The Christ who rose was not Bethlehem's babe, and it was right. For this was meant to be. Here in my head, I would not have had it otherwise. My empty arms still longed for familiar flesh. My joy, a sword that pierced through my heart. I understood more perhaps than the others when he said he could not stay with us, that it was better if he went away, was one again with God, his Father. And when the Spirit came, I once again could love my Son and know my Lord. If Easter came later for me than for the others, its brilliance was as poignant and bright.
We light the fourth Advent candle of peace. Peace I leave with you. My peace I give to you. I do not give to you as the world gives. Do not let your hearts be troubled, and do not let them be afraid. From the Gospel of John, chapter 14, verse 27. For peace, the lesson will be offered by Dustin Nguyen, and the carol will be offered by Hannah M.
To achieve shalom, we must remove the root causes of injustice and restore just relationship among people. The World Council of Churches uses the term just peace to describe the inseparable relationship between justice and peace. Indeed, the psalmist has said, "Steadfast love and faithfulness will meet, righteousness and peace will kiss each other." The work of God's shalom is not easy, for it involves working across differences. The proclamation of shalom to the world will become empty words if the communities of faith have not learned to embody shalom in their communal lives. Working for shalom requires attention to cultural and religious differences in genuine ways. For Christians, we have much to learn, since the history of Christianity has been so enmeshed with colonial enterprises like the Crusades, the conquest of the Americas, the colonization of Africa and Asia, and the suppression of other cultures and religions. Many Christians believe there is one God, one faith, and one truth. But truth is not something we possess. Rather, it is to be discovered in dialogues with one another and in working together in deep solidarity.
Hello, I'm Hannah, and this is my fiancé,
Matthew,
and we're going to play Osu song. This song is a response to the challenges of this year, and we hope this song will bring unity and love for all.
Thank you.
for Christ, the lesson will be offered by you. We will be having a group reflection using something called Jamboard, which is a way that we can all see each other's responses in one place. What we would like you to do is think about what word or phrase comes to mind when you think about the person and work of Christ, especially during this season of Advent. We had some time to talk in our breakout rooms about the markers of Advent and the way that we have seen those things, hope and love and joy in these times. And so don't think too hard about it, just whatever resonates with you. What new ways even perhaps have you seen Christ during this time? So word or phrase, what we're gonna do is go ahead and put it in chat. The chat is open for that. And our team members will be putting them on a Jamboard, and I'm going to go ahead and load that and you'll see it. And we'll hopefully be seeing our answers appear and we can all reflect on it as we go. Right. And so the chat is open. Please go ahead and you can begin giving some feedback there. So the team who is putting the stickies on, yeah, please go ahead and move those stickies around just so we can see them. When we have a page filled, there's some other pages that can be loaded. Thank you for all of you who are going ahead and entering things right now. We're seeing that Christ can be many things to many people, but most of all, we are the hands and feet of Christ. And thinking about that poem that Jason Chu shared about dumplings, it struck me that when he says that two languages that many of us are fluent in are food and sacrifice, in many ways, we're talking about the Eucharist, Christ who offered himself as our sustenance. And in so doing, maybe we do the same to one another. We're seeing some things here about reaching out to others, about service, many people talking about various ways of showing justice in a time that we see so much injustice around us, in a time that we see so much inequality. We want to make sure that when we think of the Advent wreath also, I think of with that circle and the candles, that wreath also bends in an arc. And the famous quote from Dr. King says, the arc of the universe bends towards justice. And we wanna make sure that also in Advent, yes, I see just us, that's right. That one way that we also see Christ is in us making sure that when we speak to others, when we reach out to others, when we are church to others, when we reach out, when we are courageous to face systems of oppression, when we are courageous in even facing our family and friends who we may have disagreements with, or perhaps even neighbors that we didn't know before this pandemic started, all of these things are ways that we see Christ in both the suffering and in the joy. And so maybe also, as you continue to have enter your responses there, let's just take one moment and just reflect on what we're seeing here. Perhaps something jumps out at you and think about what's resonating with you. What right now is Christ asking you to do in this Advent season, that may be a new way of seeing him and others, maybe a new way of seeing the Holy Spirit working in your life and in the lives around you. Let's just take a moment and look at the wisdom of others that is on this page here. And now that we've taken a moment to reflect on the things that we're seeing appearing on this board, let's also now take a moment to take whatever that phrase that we've either given as a gift to those who are here with us, or perhaps a phrase that has sparked something new within you. And let's just take a moment and set an intention to meditate upon that and to take action upon it in this final date, in these final days of Advent. So if you want to join me, if you feel comfortable placing your hands either on your heart or wherever it's most comfortable, where you can feel in your body the holiness of setting intention with prayer and with sacredness. And take a breath. And take another breath in. And in so doing, rejoicing that we have this breath together. And again, with this breath, set that intention that in whichever way you interact the most authentically with our Lord, that you would say, this is something I want you to root and take seed in my life and grow. Let's breathe together for another few breaths. Amen. Thank you all for participating in being the lesson and being lessons to one another. We'll light the Christ candle now for hope, love, joy, and peace. And the scripture is from Isaiah 9:6. For a child has been born for us, a son given to us. Authority rests upon his shoulders, and he is named Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. Now, thank you to all who have come wearing your festive gear and perhaps bringing an ornament. Joshua will go ahead and welcome us to some fellowship time.
I am so lucky to be a part of this, and I hope you're having a great time. And I'm so happy to also do the funnest part of the service tonight. So for all of you who have put in your effort and you have brought any kind of ornaments that mean a lot to you, or if you have a hat that's special to you, please show it off. Go on to your view and then gallery, and you can see everyone. And we are just going to take a look to see who has some cool stuff to show. And guess what? You're gonna get my famous LA Diocese lemon bars. and they will be hand delivered to you before Christmas. So that's to reward everyone who has put in so much effort into this. So don't be shy. You can turn on your view if you want to participate. Boy, I see a lot of lights going on right now. I see Greta with her lights. And I see, what else do I see? Oh my goodness, there are pets, there are animals. I don't think those count, sorry. Let's see, what else? Wow, what does Melissa have?
Hats.
All hats, is that four hats?
Yeah, I just made them with the yarn.
Oh, cool.
and you wrap it around the toilet paper and push it up and put some cotton in, and you have a little. Oh. It's on the internet, everybody.
That's a good one. Very good. Anything else? Ornaments, hats? We've got Edward with a beautiful sparkling stallion horse. Oh, what does Shirley have? Unmute yourself, Shirley. What is that?
A Hawaiian angel.
Oh, is that an ornament? Yeah. Great, that's beautiful.
Hey, there's not a lot of brown colored ornaments.
Why have a Hawaiian?
This is your Pacific Islander representation.
Okay, that's great. Phoebe, what do I see you wear? Your hat, unmute yourself.
I got my hat.
Look at that hat.
It's the Advent hat.
Advent hat, uh-oh.
Can you see this? The words there?
Oh, there's words to it.
Yeah, it's English, Chinese, and sign language.
Wow,
okay. And there are pictures here.
Melissa, I think you have competition.
Well, about this? This is Mom's Angel.
Okay. Oh, that's
this is all made by things in the kitchen.
Oh, wow.
This is a funnel.
Oh, it's a funnel.
See?
Very creative. Very creative. This is
a wrap for the pier. The pier.
Very nice. Very nice. Okay. Did I miss anyone else? Okay, so I have the honor of being the judge and jury also.
That's
so I think that we're gonna have one hat winner, which is Phoebe.
Ooh.
And one hat winner, we're gonna do two hat winners. And Melissa is gonna be the second hat winner. And then I think Shirley's gonna be the ornament winner. Okay, so that's great. So can you send me your email and your address and make sure that we have it? You can write it in the chat, okay? So we have that. Yeah, so it's very important we have your information so we can get a hold of that. So thank you so much, everyone, for participating in our contest. So look forward to next year. So get ready to start, you know, thinking about it. So we're gonna go into announcements right now. We wanna welcome everyone to another gathering event. And if you are here for the first time, please keep your eyes out for our upcoming events. You can find everything on our website, which is thegatheringedla.org. So please visit that. For all our upcoming events, the planning committee is hard at work planning some really, really great upcoming topics. So we're really hope that you can participate. Also, there's something new called the Gathering Spot. The Gathering Spot is going to meet every month, and it's just a social gathering place where you can get to know each other and people can pray for you, you can share. It's just a social time. So our first one will be January 6th at 5 o'clock to 6 o'clock. And it's always gonna be the first Wednesday of the month. And that will also be in our website. So please look out for that. So that's a great time because all of these wonderful events, we're getting more and more people joining, which is wonderful, but we don't get a chance to know each other as closely as we want. So please join the Gathering Spot. And there are also other great events coming up. So please check that out. Okay, so I will hand the time back to Mel.
Okay, so I am going to get something queued up for y'all. And this one is going to be a carol. So let me share my screen first. So for the carol for Christ, you will be hearing, O Come All Ye Faithful, offered by the Gathering Quartet. It's a special little gift here.
Hard to listen to you singing in public, but thank you all for joining us today on behalf of the gathering. It is always a beautiful occasion to see your faces online or in person. Have a blessed Advent and a Merry Christmas. I will end with a closing prayer, a blessing for traveling in the dark. Go slow if you can, slower, more slowly still. Friendly, dark, or fearsome, this is no place to break your neck by rushing, by running, by crashing into what you cannot see. Then again, it is true, different darks have different tasks. And if you have arrived here unawares, if you have come in peril or in pain. This might be no place you should dawdle. I do not know what these shadows ask of you, what they might hold that means you good or ill. It is not for me to reckon whether you should linger or you should leave, but this is what I can ask of you, that in the darkness there is a blessing, that in the shadows there is a welcome, that in the night you be encompassed by the love that knows your name. Blessings to you all. Have a great evening.